गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, एम आई ऑडिबल? एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू ऑल?
यस सर।
यस। We have done blood. Have you any doubt in blood pump? You can say blood part or digestive system part. Have you any doubt in blood or digestive system that you people want to ask? No, let's see. Let's see. Let's do a question. One question is there. Question number 1, everyone. Question number 1, a person with blood group A can donate blood to and receive blood from. You just think, this is option A and this is option B. Donate blood is option A and receive blood from option A. Options, your options are: A is person with blood group AB and B is person with any blood group. Dusra, second one. A is person with blood group A or AB and B is blood groups. Okay, your third option is A is person with blood group B or AB and B is B or O blood group. Fourth option is person with any blood group and B is O blood group only. Please solve, everyone. What I told, you all can solve it. Okay, don't over try. Okay, or try to do it too fast. Please think and then answer. Anybody having doubt in this question or not able to solve can ask me. Okay, I think you people can do it easily. Now, one important thing is blood clotting. One important thing is blood clotting. Let's see. Blood clotting. What is blood clotting? Do you people know what is blood clotting? Actually, what happens? Blood clotting, it is the formation of clot after any injury. You people can observe easily that once injury is there, you can say to a person, he or she starts bleeding, and after some time, bleeding is going to stop on its own. Okay, no other intervention is needed, and that phenomena is known as blood clotting. It involves 13 clotting factors. Yes or no? It involves 13 clotting factors that are there. Factor 1 is fibrinogen. Factor 2 is prothrombin. Factor 3 is thromboplastin. Factor 4 is calcium ion Ca+2. This is very important. You can say factor 4 is. Factor 5 is proaxillarine. Okay. Factor 6 is not isolated yet, but it is there. Factor 7, serum prothrombin conversion accelerator. Now you see, factor 8 is known as anti-hemophilic factor. But anti-hemophilic factor means deficiency of factor 8 is going to cause a disease known as hemophilia. Yes or no? I'm writing over here. Deficiency of factor 8 will cause hemophilia, and that also hemophilia A, if somebody will ask you, because hemophilia is of many types. Hemophilia is a bleeding disorder in which blood clotting do not take place easily. Yes or no? Factor 9 is known as Christmas factor. And factor 10 is a Stewart power factor or thrombokinase. This also you people need to remember, thrombokinase. Factor 11, factor 12 is Hagman factor. Factor 13 is fibrin stabilizing factor. You will ask me, sir, what all use are there? Actually, blood clotting having two pathway. One is known as extrinsic pathway. One is known as intrinsic pathway. Try to understand my point. Extrinsic pathway and intrinsic pathway. Yes or no? Extrinsic pathway. Have you people heard about these things earlier? Or have you any doubt in this? Let's see. You people know the meaning of extrinsic factor or intrinsic factor, na? Extrinsic means coming from outside. Intrinsic means coming from inside. Yes or no? Now see, this is your blood vessel. This is your blood vessel. You got some injury. Okay. You got some injury here. For say, this is blood vessel. Okay. Injury will be there in this area, in the tissue, and that will start extrinsic pathway. Means injury is from tissue trauma, not from blood vessel. Now, if impact is there, it is going to damage the wall of blood vessel also. In that case, it will start from inside, and that will be known as intrinsic pathway. Yes or no? So intrinsic pathway starts from inside the blood vessel, and extrinsic pathway starts from outside the blood vessel due to tissue trauma. Yes or no? Please let me know. Have you people understood meaning of extrinsic or intrinsic pathway? Everyone clear with it? Yes. Let's see. Now, clotting of blood is not a single reaction. Clotting of blood is not a single reaction. Rather, it involves a, you can say, series of reaction. Yes or no? It involves a series of reaction. Yes or no? Series of reaction is like, try to understand my point. Whenever you are having trauma from the blood vessel, you try to understand my point. This is your blood vessel. This is the outer wall. And here is epithelium. Here is epithelium. Yes or no? Epithelium. If and in this what outer wall, collagen fibers are there. What are there? Collagen fibers are there. Try to understand my point. Now, if injury will be there over here. Let's see. For say, here is injury. In that case, blood will contact this wall, na? Tell me, yes or no? If injury will be there on the, you can say, in the inner lining of blood vessel, in that case, blood vessel will contact the wall, na, in which collagen fiber is there. Yes or no? Or a yes or no? Yes. Hariharan is saying yes. Anybody else? See, this is going to help you people a lot. So intrinsic pathway starts. Factor 12 is activated by factor 11. You can say factor 12 is activated due to this injury. Factor 12 is going to activate factor 11. Factor 11 will be activating factor 9. So factor 12, 11, 9 is activated. Now 9, with the help of factor 8, factor 4, this is factor 4, Ca++, and 10 will be activated to factor 10A. Factor 11, with the help of factor, you can say 8, getting my point, and factor 4 will activate factor 10. So what happened? Factor 12, then 11, then 9, then 8, then 10. This is the sequence, na, in intrinsic pathway. Agreed, everyone? What is factor 10? What is factor 10? Thrombokinase. Agreed? What is factor 10? Is it thrombokinase or not? Factor 12, then 11, then 9, then 8, then 10. Yes or no? And what is the name of factor 10? Please tell me. What is the name of factor 10? In your NCERT and all, you will find it by this name. Yes or no? It is thrombokinase. Now thrombokinase is why Adit, why you are saying so that numbering mistake is there? Six is, you can say six is not there, that is why you are saying six is actually, I have told six is not isolated actually, okay? That is why it is not written. This, you can say, table is taken from a book of medical physiology, Guyton and Hall. It is quite correct. Completely correct. Don't worry. Okay. I have not made this. So, chance of human error is not there. I have just taken that because I have cut that table and pasted over here. Okay, so you see what I have told. Thrombokinase is activated now. Till here, any you can say doubt is there? Any doubt is there till here? No, not at all. Now, one thing I will say over here. See, here. Now, how extrinsic pathway is starting? Some injury on the, you can say, on the outer side of the blood vessel. Injury is there. So what happened? Tissue trauma, and that lead to tissue factor activation. Factor 3, factor 7, and that has also activated factor 10. Yes or no? So you people can see from both the pathways what happened eventually. Eventually, factor 10 got activated. Yes or no? Factor 10 got activated. Yes or no? Everyone? Yes. Now, what happens after activation of factor 10? See over here. What factor 10 is doing? See in this diagram. You have to see few things only. Factor 10 got activated. Now, see over here. It will be converting prothrombin into thrombin. It will be converting prothrombin into thrombin. Yes or no? Factor 10 is converting prothrombin into thrombin. Yes or no? Prothrombin into, what can I write over here? Thrombokinase, yes or no? Yes or no? After activation of factor 10, what happened? Prothrombin got converted into thrombin. Yes or no? Agreed? Now, this thrombin is going to convert fibrinogen into fibrin threads. Like fibrinogen were like this. That got converted into fibrin threads like this. A meshwork is formed. And in this meshwork, cells got trapped. Cells got trapped. Yes or no? In this meshwork, cells got trapped. Yes or no? Agreed? You must have observed the clot that is formed earlier or in the early part of blood clotting that is very soft. Yes or no? That is very soft. Even if you will touch it, it will start bleeding again. Yes or no? Please reply. After that only I can move. I told the clot that is formed due to this fibrin clot and the blood cells that got trapped inside it, that is very soft in earlier part. Okay, even if you will touch it with, you can say, your finger, it will start bleeding again. Have you felt this thing? Yes. So what happens? After that, you will see some yellowish fluid start oozing out from here. Yellowish fluid start oozing out from here. What's that? No, that is not pus, dear. That is serum. Now you see, all the clotting factor were exhausted. Yes or no? All the clotting factor were exhausted during clotting. Yes or no? Please reply yes or not. Yes. Only Gayatri is saying yes. Now, do you think any clotting factor is there in the serum? Do you think any clotting factor left in the serum? No. So, blood plasma without clotting factor is known as serum. A important definition over here. So actually serum cannot clot. Serum cannot clot. Agreed? Just a minute. Yes. So serum is plasma without clotting factor. Yes or no? Everyone? Blood having two components now. One is cell, one is plasma. So now from now, you can say from this, we are going to take a very important, you can say, inference from here. Plasma can clot, but serum cannot. Yes or no? Because serum lacks clotting factor. Yes or no? Serum is plasma without clotting factor. Agreed? Everyone? Others can also answer. Okay. As I have told you, you people. Yes. We will be discussing. First, solve a question over here. There is a question. Blood clotting involves. The conversion of first prothrombin to thromboplastin, second thromboplastin to prothrombin, third fibrinogen to fibrin, and fibrin to फाइब्रिनोजन, फाइब्रिनोजन, प्लीज आंसर, प्लीज आंसर, टेक योर टाइम, प्लीज आंसर. थ्रोम्बोप्लास्टिन यू पीपल कैन सी फ्रॉम हियर. थर्ड फैक्टर इज नोन एज थ्रोम्बोप्लास्टिन. सो व्हाट डू यू थिंक? Agreed? What do you think? What should be the answer? What do you think? Answer should be 3. Is it like that? No issue? Now, have you seen this one? Have you seen this one? Have you gone for a blood test? Have you seen this kind of tube? See what is written over here. EDTA. Is it written EDTA? Tell me, dear. EDTA is written, na? Yes. Do you know what is the full form of EDTA? It is ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. What will it do? If you are going to put blood, try to understand. If you have to perform blood investigation, in that case, what will you do? Blood should be in the uncoagulated form or in coagulated form. If you have to do it properly, blood should be in coagulated form or uncoagulated. If it will be coagulated, you will not be able to perform any of the investigation that you people require. So blood should be in uncoagulated form. It should not coagulate till investigation is performed. So what they do? They have lined this tube with the help of EDTA. Yes or no? They are going to line this tube with the help of EDTA. And that EDTA will combine with all the Ca+2. And in that case, what will happen? Blood will not coagulate. Agreed? In that case, blood will not coagulate. Agreed, everyone? And it will reach the lab in uncoagulated form. Because you people know, na, Ca+2 is required for coagulation. If EDTA will consume all the Ca+2, in that case, clotting can take place. In that case, clotting can take place or not? Tell me. No. So, that is why it is lined by EDTA. Now, one question that I think Aditya has asked, that sir, what is the role of platelet in coagulation? See, actually platelet helps in aggregation, and one is von Willebrand factor, and that is going to help in attachment. That factor is beyond your scope, that is why I have not discussed. Okay, so platelet is going to help you with aggregation. Yes or no? If platelet will not be there, the aggregation of cells and all cannot take place. Yes or no? Yes or no? Anybody who has not understood? Aditya, have you got this thing? Tell me. Platelet help with aggregation of cells. Tell me. Aggregation means all the cells are coming together. All the cells are coming together. Okay? Okay. Now, which vitamin is needed? Vitamin needed for what? Coagulation. It is vitamin K. Okay. In absence of vitamin K, disease can be there. Yes or no? In absence of vitamin K, disease can be there. Many diseases can be there. You can say coagulation disorder will be there. Agreed? Everyone? Yes. It has stopped. I am sharing again. So that's all with blood part. Okay. Now, we will be talking about heart. We will be talking about human heart. Let's see. Human heart. What do you understand? For what purpose heart is there? Heart is just like a pump. Yes or no? Try to understand. What happens in simple organism? What happens in them? All the cells, are in contact with what? All the cells are in contact with environment. So they can directly exchange. But when you will talk about complex organism like human, okay, deep-seated cells are there. Yes or no? Deep-seated cells are there. Everyone, they cannot directly exchange with, you can say, environment. So there is a need for a system which supplies nutrition, which removes, so you can say, nutrition and oxygen, and which removes waste and carbon dioxide. Both are required in this case. Yes or no? Both are required in this case. Agreed, everyone? Now, for that, circulatory system is there. Okay? It is just like a supply line that is there. In that, blood we have done. Now we will be talking about heart. Yes or no? Heart is there. What is the location of heart? We'll talk about that. This is your lung. Okay, and here, you see, in the this is right lung. This is left lung. And you people can see, there is a notch present in the left lung that is known as cardiac notch. What? Cardiac notch. So, the heart is present between the lung, okay, in a notch present inside left lung known as cardiac notch. Yes or no? Known as cardiac notch. Getting my point? See over here. This cavity is known as mediastinum. This cavity is known as mediastinum. Agreed, everyone? The cavity in which heart is present is known as what? Mediastinum. No issues? What is the size of heart? If you will talk about the size, it is the size of a clenched fist. Okay. Have you understood meaning of clenched fist? Tell me, dear. Have you understood that? Yes. It is the size like that only. Okay. Some standardized techniques were there. In this, it is the size of clenched fist. Now, a structure. If you will talk about covering of heart, you see over here, the inner covering of heart is known as visceral pericardium. And this outer covering is known as parietal. The parietal word is known as for outer one. And the visceral is for inner. So inner covering is visceral. Outer covering is parietal. Agreed, everyone? Between them, there is a space that is known as pericardial cavity. There is a space that is known as pericardial cavity. Agreed? Everyone, please tell me. Agreed, no? So, pericardial cavity is there. It is filled with pericardial fluid. What is the function of pericardial fluid? If you will see, they are going to protect the heart from shock. Like you are jumping, it will protect the heart from getting a shock that is transferred due to your jumping, walking, etc. And it also prevent friction. Yes or no? Otherwise, your heart is going to rub from the body wall. Yes or no? Agreed? Yes. Two things are there. Now, if you will talk about wall of heart, the outermost wall, you can say outermost layer of the wall is going to be known as epicardium. It is the outermost layer. Then the middle layer, that is myocardium. Then the middle layer, that is myocardium. Agreed? Then the middle layer, that is myocardium. Let's see. It is the middle layer. And it is made up of cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle. Then comes endocardium. It is the innermost layer. Agreed? Now, the question is, which layer of heart wall is made up of cardiac muscle? Cardiac muscle. One is epicardium, the second is myocardium, the third is endocardium, fourth is parietal pleura. What do you think? What should be the answer? What do you think? What should be the answer? Yes, Shraddha, it is myocardium. ओके, इट इज मेड अप ऑफ कार्डियक मसल. सी नाउ एज फार एज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ह्यूमन हार्ट इज कंसर्न, एज फार एज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ह्यूमन हार्ट इज कंसर्न, लेट सी फर्स्ट. आई एम गोइंग टू रब फ्यू थिंग्स, आफ्टर दैट वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग इन डिटेल. फर्स्ट आई विल लाइक टू रब फ्यू थिंग्स. नाउ सी व्हाट इज देयर. As far as your heart is concerned, getting my point? Your heart is going to be formed. Getting my point? Your heart is going to be formed of four chambers. Yes or no? Depends between first two layers you told about, and the third layer you just explained, because they both are covering right. What are you trying to ask? Tell me, dear, that I have not understood. First two layers, epicardium and myocardium.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, the visceral pericardium and the parietal pericardium, I didn't understand the difference of like where they are actually present. Because both
both of them are present outside heart. Yes or no? Getting my point? You take anything, you cover it by one. You can say anything. You can say you take foil paper or anything. You leave some space and you put, you can say, second foil paper. Getting my point? Something like that. Heart is there. It is wrapped, you can say, from outside, first by visceral pericardium and then by parietal pericardium. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Did you get it? Heart is covered by two membranes. Agreed? Do you people know what is the role of peritoneum? Leave it. What I have told, just try to understand over here. Heart is going to have two coverings. One is the visceral pericardium, another is parietal pericardium, and there is a little space present between them. That is known as pericardial cavity or pericardial space. In that, pericardial fluid is present. Now you people agree?
Yes, sir, I understood.
Shraddha, you understood, na?
Yes, sir, got it.
Yes, anybody else having doubt? Adit, you are saying no, sir. For what? And the three layers you just explained, because they are both are covering. See, you have also asked about this, Sradhana, epicardium, myocardium, and endocardium.
No, sir, I got confused between the two sets of layers you just explained. I thought all of them are the same, so now I got to know what they are.
No. One is the covering of heart, and one, these three are there in the wall of heart. Actually, this one and this one, both are fused only. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Yes. Now, if we will talk, your heart is going to be formed of four chambers, two atria and two ventricles. Do you people know? You keep on listening, atria or auricle. Is the atria and auricle are same? Is the atria and auricle are same or not? Are they same? Everyone, I want from you people, what is the difference between atria and auricle? Please respond. is the atria and auricle are same? No, they are not same actually. What happens over here, if you will see, in this diagram, they have not mentioned about auricle actually. I'm going to explain to you people what is about auricle is there. Auricle are not the main chamber, rather that is a accessory chamber. Chamber of atria. What is this? They are the accessory chamber of atria. Yes or no? Main chamber is atria and it is present, getting my point? It is present to assist atria only. When more blood has to be accommodated, in that case, this chamber will be used. Saying atria or auricle is wrong. You see, here they have written. See, this small structure is auricle. Agreed? Everyone, you got it? Now, yes, let's see. So two atria and two ventricles are there. Let's see. What is this? This is interatrial septum. Interatrial septum, that is the septum present between two atria. It separates two atrial chambers. Agreed? Now, if I will talk like you can say from this point of view, this is what? What is this? Interventricular septum between the two ventricles. This is right atrium. This is right ventricle. This is left atrium. This is left ventricle. Yes or no? Everyone, please note it. Everyone, no issues? Now you see over here. Between the left atria and the ventricle, atrioventricular septum is there. That separates atria and ventricle. Yes or no? Yes or no? Everyone? No issues? Now, here between atria and ventricle, there are valves present. Let's see. If I will like to let's see. Here, a valve is present between atria and ventricle. There is atrioventricular septum, but you can say you people understand that there have to be some communication, and that communication is guarded by some valves. Name of this valve is bicuspid valve. What? Bicuspid valve. So if somebody will ask you, this is left atrium, this is right atrium. If somebody will ask you like this, the question is, which valve is present in the left atrial septum? Tell me, which valve should be there? What is the name of that valve, dear? It is bicuspid valve. And in the right side, it is tricuspid valve. Agreed? Everyone, from the right side it is, yes, it is interatrial septum. This complete structure is interatrial septum, but there is an opening present, and that opening has to be guarded by a valve. It will let the blood come from atrium to ventricle, but will not let it flow back. Agreed, dear? Tell me. Sorry, what have I written? Oh, sorry, you are right. It is atrioventricular septum only. I have written it mistakenly. Let's see. It is atrioventricular septum. Yes, you are all, you can say, damn right. Let's see. You got it? Hariharan, you got it? Adit, you are right. Of course. Yes. I have made a mistake over here. So which valve is present? This is in atrioventricular septum only, na? Now, here it is tricuspid valve. Agreed? Now, everyone will try to understand. This is inferior vena cava, and here is superior vena cava. Here is superior vena cava. What is there? Vena cava. Blood, deoxygenated blood, means blood without oxygen from the lower part of the body, returns to right atrium via which blood vessel? From the lower part of body, it returns via which blood vessel? You can say, collect blood from the lower part of the body and deliver it inside the right atrium. Yes or no? Everyone. Done? And from the superior part of the body, blood is collected and is put inside right atrium by superior vena cava. So what are, you can say, vena cava is meant for, what is the function of vena cava, dear? It is the collection of deoxygenated blood and returning it to the right atrium. Agreed? Everyone? Your heart is four-chambered. What in other organisms like amphibia? Before that, Pisces or Fishes. Reptiles, and mammals. What do you think? How many chambers are there in the heart of Fishes? I'm going to explain it to you, dear. Give me 2 minutes. In two-chambered heart, open circulatory system, I'm going to discuss with you people. Fishes, here, two-chambered heart is there. In amphibia, it is three-chambered. In reptiles, it is three, or you can say incomplete four chamber. Because interventricular septum starts forming, exception is, what is the exception for reptiles? Exception is crocodile. Exception is crocodile, yes or no? Because crocodile is having four chambered heart. Mammals having four chambered as well as here crocodile is also there. Everyone, do you have any doubt in this? Now the question is, let's see. Question is, the heart of amphibian is usually first two-chambered, second is three-chambered, third is four-chambered, fourth is three and a half chamber. What do you people think? Yes, it is three chamber. Do you know? It was asked in KBPY SA 2016. It is asked in that only. Agreed, everyone? Now, few more important things we will like to let's see. What I want to tell you all, few more things I want to tell you people. See, when pressure increases inside ventricle, what is the chance? Okay. Let's see. What I have told over here, if pressure increases inside the ventricle, what is the chance? There is chance this valve will get everted. Getting open, everted. Like valve will open this way. And the blood will start flowing from ventricle to atria. That should not happen. To prevent that, there are cords that are there. There are cords that are there which connects the valve from papillary muscles. These valves are known as cauda tendini. What? Cauda tendini. I am making another diagram so that you people can clear, you can say, see this thing clearly. So what do you think? What is the function of cauda tendini? It is preventing eversion of valve this way. When the ventricle is contracting, yes or no? Tell me, dear. Everyone. Have you? Yes. So see this question. If cauda tendini of left side is cut, then what will happen? Can see this, you can say these options and answer. Agreed. Agreed, everyone? No issues. This question is done. Na? If you are going to cut this contact tendon, in that case, during contraction, blood will flow back. Agreed? Now, how your heart is going to contract? For that, some tissues are responsible. And what is the name of those tissue? They are known as nodal tissue. Nodal tissue. What are they? They are modified cardiac muscle. Yes or no? They are modified cardiac muscle. They are not nerves. They are modified cardiac muscle. Yes or no? Nodal tissue. Agreed, everyone? And they are responsible for contraction of your heart. So, contraction of your heart is taking due to a muscle or a nerve. What I have told? I have told nodal tissues are responsible for contraction of heart, of your heart. Getting my point? Nodal tissues are there. So here, if you will see, they are cardiac muscles. So for contraction of your heart, muscle is responsible or nerve is responsible. Everyone. Hariharan is saying muscle. Shraddha is saying muscle. Anybody else, please? Please, everyone. Muscle. Only Hariharan and Shraddha is saying, nobody else having any idea about this or nothing to say? You should answer. Then only I will move ahead. I have told, for your heart contraction, what is responsible? A nerve or muscle? Aditya? Kinsuk is saying muscle. Anybody else? Aditya is saying muscle, I think, sir. I have written muscle is there. Gayatri is saying muscle. Anybody else? Ritu? Saswat? Sambhu? See, SAN, sinoatrial node, is the part of...
So I'm not able to message you.
Okay, no. So it is muscle, na? Anybody else? See, that is muscle. Getting my point? You are saying SAN, sinoatrial node. That is also part of nodal tissue only. Getting my point? So human heart is myogenic. The heart that is going to get its, try to understand my point. The heart that is getting its, you can say, impulse or a stimulus from the muscle. That kind of heart is known as myogenic heart. Okay. But heart of lower organism are neurogenic. They require, like in earthworm and all, they require nerves to fire. That is known as neurogenic heart. So human heart is myogenic or neurogenic? Tell me. Myogenic. Agreed, everyone? That nodal tissue having these kind of things. See over here. This is SA node. This is AB node. Connected by internodal fibers. Then AB bundle is running through the interventricular septum. And you can see from the end, small fibers are getting originated. Yes or no? That is known as Purkinje fiber. Together, they are going to be known as bundle of His. Against the name of its discoverer, Sir Wilhelm His Jr., he was a Swiss cardiologist. Yes or no? Have you people understood? SA node, AB node, then AB bundle and these smaller fibers are known as Purkinje fiber. Together they will be known as bundle of His, Sir Wilhelm His Jr. Agreed? Yes. Sinoatrial node is known as pacemaker and situated in the upper right corner of right atrium. AB node is known as pace setter, situated at the lower left corner of right atrium. Everyone, agree with this? Agree with this? So this is that only that we have discussed already. Now, one important thing. What is going to be the pathway? What is going to be the pathway? Let's see. One important thing. Let's see. What do you people say about the pathway? Why I am asking that? Let's see. Have you heard about single circulation, double circulation, and incomplete double circulation? Have you heard about that? Tell me. What's that? What's that? Let's see. Actually, if you will talk about blood vascular system, it is open type and closed type. In open type, capillary system is not present. What is a capillary system? Let's see. This is your organ. Blood vessel will enter your organ, will break into capillaries and will leave like a vein. No point of time, the blood vessel is moving out of its, you can say blood vessel. No point of time, the blood vessel is moving out of its, you can say blood vessel. Blood is not moving out of it, always remaining inside it. Only exchange is going to take place. This is known as capillary. So actually capillary system is absent in the open circulation and it is present in the, if it is closed by blood vascular system, it is having three pathways. One is single circulation, one is incomplete double circulation, another is complete double circulation. Yes or no? Please let me know. Complete double circulation, incomplete double circulation, and single circulation. Yes or no? Everyone? See, let's see. In single circulation, heart is two chambered, atria and ventricle. Blood is flowing into ventricle from atria. From atria, it is going to go into gills. Here it will get oxygen and becomes oxygenated. It will go into the organ, supply the oxygen, becomes deoxygenated blood, and it is coming to atria. Here it is deoxygenated. In the ventricle also, it is deoxygenated, and from the ventricle, it is leaving like a deoxygenated blood. Yes or no? Anybody having any doubt in this? Have you any doubt? Tell me, dear. Tell me, dear. Now, tell me one more thing. It is important. At any point of time, the heart is receiving oxygenated blood. At any point of time, the heart is receiving oxygenated blood. Tell me, dear. No. So if somebody will ask you in which type of circulation, heart do not, or heart at all not receiving the oxygenated blood, what will you say? Which type of circulation is there? Say. single circulation. Yes, it is there in the feces. Now, incomplete double circulation. It is having two atria and only one ventricle. It is having two atria and only one ventricle. Let's see. Agreed? Let's see. The atria is two and ventricle is one. Now, from here, blood is coming, and from here also blood is coming. Left side of atria is receiving oxygenated blood. Which kind of blood? Blood with oxygen. And right atrium is receiving deoxygenated blood. Yes or no? Any doubt in that? Any doubt in that? No? Tell me, dear. Both kind of blood is getting mixed into it. Both kind of blood is getting mixed into ventricle. So from ventricle, here also mixed blood is coming and here also mixed blood is coming. So gills, lungs or skin, they are receiving mixed blood as well as the body is receiving the mixed blood. Yes or no? Mixing of blood is, here two pathways are formed, but they got mixed inside ventricle. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Yes. This kind of circulation is there in amphibia, reptilia, except crocodile. Now, the most important one. The complete double circulation part. Heart is four chambered, crocodile, apes and mammalia. See over here. From the left ventricle originating oxygenated blood through aorta, it is going to the body. Here oxygen is supplied, and from the body, the blood that is, you can say, moving out is, tell me, from the body, the blood which is going out is deoxygenated blood, and it is entering the right atrium through vena cava. Yes or no? It is entering the right atrium through vena cava. Yes or no? Everyone should reply, dear. If you are not getting these things are very important. You will end up in problem, you can say, after that. Do you people agree? Hariharan and Shraddha is agreeing. Anybody else? Clear? Aditya is saying clear. Anybody else? Yes. Let's see. What I am saying, dear, here, from the right atrium, the blood is moving out through pulmonary artery. Through which artery? Pulmonary artery. Agreed? So, what do you think? Which kind of blood is there in pulmonary artery? Oxygenated or deoxygenated? What kind of blood is being carried by deoxygenated? Rest other artery in your body is going to carry oxygenated blood. Now, from here it will go into lung. From lung originating pulmonary vein. After getting oxygen, it will become oxygenated. Which kind of blood is flowing into pulmonary vein? Which kind of blood is flowing into pulmonary vein? Oxygenated, agreed? Oxygenated blood is flowing inside, in rest of the vein. deoxygenated blood is going to be there. Everyone agree for this? Yes or no? Now, one question is there. The pulmonary artery carries first deoxygenated blood to the lung. Second, oxygenated blood to brain. Third, oxygenated blood to the lung. Fourth, deoxygenated blood to the kidney. Tell me, dear, what is there? Anybody having doubt in this? This question was asked in KBPUI essay 2014. Tell me, dear. Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this? Others can also answer. Some of you are just not responding at all. Please respond. I have a habit of that. Okay. Usually in my class, 70 to 80 students are sitting. Okay. Even then, I allow them to respond. Otherwise, I do not feel like you can say communication is proper. If you are getting, you let me know. If you are not getting, you please say, sir, I have not understood, so that I can do something in time. Okay. Understood this question, dear? If somebody is not able to solve, please let me know. Everyone. So have you people understood about these things? Now, some disease of circulatory system. Some disease of circulatory system. Let's see. Disease of heart, that is there. Disease of heart, disorders. Do you people know what all disorders are there? That is there, that is related to heart. Let's see, dear. Here is a blood vessel known as coronary artery. Coronary artery is going to supply blood to the heart wall. Do you people understand this thing? Even the blood, just give me a minute. Let me make it suitable for you all first. Yes. Yes, let's see. Do you people know heart muscle wall also needs some? Heart muscle wall also needs some oxygen because they are living cell too. They are also living cells, na? Tell me, dear. Isn't it? So if I will talk like that, if they are living cell, in that case, are they require oxygen? The heart muscle wall cells or muscle cells that are there. They will require oxygen, na? They will require oxygen, na? Tell me. Yes. That oxygen is going to be supplied by coronary artery. Which artery is going to supply blood to heart muscle wall? Which artery is there? Which artery is going to supply coronary artery? Great. Now you see, due to something that had happened, you see, try to understand my point. Oh, I have to make it. So you will not understand. See, what had happened? Try to understand. One process is there that is known as atherosclerosis. What? Atherosclerosis. Due to deposition of cholesterol and all, the lumen of this blood vessel started getting narrow over here. Let's see. It got narrowed down. It got narrowed down like this. Here you people can feel it. Do you think that the muscle wall is going to get ample oxygen now after atherosclerosis? No. Hariharan saying no. So atherosclerosis is deposition of cholesterol, calcium, fiber, etc. in coronary artery. This will lead to decreased blood supply to heart muscle. Yes or no? A few people agree. After atherosclerosis, the blood supply to the, you can say, heart muscle will, you can say, increase or decrease. After it will decrease. If it will not get ample, you can say, blood, in that case, it will not get ample oxygen. This will lead to decreased blood supply is known as ischemia. And decreased oxygen supply to heart is known as hypoxia. Yes or no? Hypoxia. Agreed? Everyone. Atherosclerosis had happened. After that, ischemia has taken place. And after ischemia, what had happened here? Hypoxia is there. And in that case, the patient will start feeling a pain inside the chest, acute chest pain. That is known as angina pectoris. What is the name of that chest pain? Angina pectoris. Till now, you people have understood or not? Yes. Hypoxia is decreased oxygen supply. Clear. Saswat is saying clear. Now, if I will try to treat the patient, in that case, the pain may be relieved. If we are not able to relieve the pain, in that case, what will happen? The heart muscle will die. It will be dead. And that condition is known as heart attack or myocardial infarction. What is this? What is this? Tell me, dear. What is this? Myocardial infarction or heart attack is irreversible damage to heart muscle. In that case, what you can do? At that time, if aspirin tablet is there, you can give 300 mg of aspirin to the patient. Okay? Agreed? Or a streptokinase is there. A streptokinase is an enzyme secreted from bacteria streptococcus. Yes or no? It is clot buster. It will dissolve the clot. Yes or no? Everyone. Myocardial infarction is there due to what? Due to some clot or atherosclerosis. So how we are going to treat it? We will try to treat it by blood thinning agent. That is aspirin. Yes or no? You may have seen that many of you Agreed? You may have seen that thing. You can say old aged person in your house, maybe take you, you can say maybe on aspirin. Yes or no? Everyone. Tell me, dear. Tell me. Have you understood till heart attack? Have you people understood till heart attack? Now, what will happen? After heart attack, what will happen? Will the heart be able to? Yes, aspirin is there. If blood is going to be, you can say, thinned a bit, getting my point, you will get some time for surgery and all. So that is the emergency treatment that we are going to give. Okay. Aspirin can be given in myocardial infarction, as well as you can say streptokinase can be given. Okay, at your level, you try to understand like that only. Otherwise, many other conditions are there that a doctor looks for, you can say look for. Agreed? Aspirin is a blood thinning agent only. Okay, many of you can say old aged person in your house may be using it. Yes or no? The grandfather and all. Agreed? Everyone? Say yes or no. Clear? Yes. Now I will say, atherosclerosis has taken place, ischemia after that, hypoxia after that, angina pectoris after that. If not treated in time, myocardial infarction has taken place. Do you think any pressure or any change is going to be there in the pumping activity of heart? Do you think it is going to happen? Is there any change in pumping, you can say, capacity of heart? If some part of heart is damaged, some part of heart wall is damaged, will the heart pump, you can say, blood like earlier, or it will decrease? It will decrease. Yes, of course it will decrease. So your body is going to get less amount of blood, na? Now, so when do one fail? As a student, when we fail, when we are not able to score that much, which is required to pass the exam. Heart will fail when the heart will not be able to meet the demand of the body. That will be what? Heart failure. That will be what? Heart failure. Agreed? Everyone? Yes. Heart failure or cardiac failure. So there is a difference between heart attack and heart failure. Once heart attack will be there, after that heart failure will be, you can say, will take place. And this condition cannot continue for long. After some time, heart will say, I am not going to beat anymore. Once heart will stop, as you can say, stop beating, that condition will be known as cardiac arrest. Yes or no? Let's see what they will do. They can perform angiography. Angiography. By angiography, what happens? They are going to inject a radioactive dye. That dye will make everything white. But that, let's see. I have injected a radioactive dye and I am taking a photograph. Wherever the blood is flowing, it will become white. Okay. And the in area where blood is not flowing, it will be black only. Okay. If this kind of photo will be there, that means in this area, some constriction is there. Okay. Means in this area, this lumen is narrowed down. Yes or no? So by angiography, you will get to know where the blockage is there. Agreed? Everyone? radioactive dye will be injected in the blood. Wherever it will go, it will look like it is white. Yes or no? Getting more? You can say not radioactive actually. That you can say radio opaque will be the right word. Okay? It is the diagnostic. I will say radio opaque. Let's see. Radio opaque. Okay? So radio opaque dye will be injected, and by angiography we will find out where the blockage is actually. Yes or no? Now, what will I do? I will insert a with the help of camera and all, we are going to insert it here. I am going to make it swell over here. That is like a balloon. At this end, balloon is there. We are going to inflate that, you can say that balloon. It will push it outwards. And I will leave a stent over here. That is known as angioplasty. Getting my point? You people try to think for 2 minutes. I am just coming back. Give me a minute. Yes, dear. Have you people understood this thing? Angiography and angioplasty, what is the difference? Yes, you are right. That is dangerous. There is chance of rupture of blood vessel. Getting my point? There is chance of rupture of blood vessel. Usually, this is done in the younger person. Angioplasty is done in younger person, because their blood vessel is elastic, that is not going to rupture that easily. Okay, a person having, you can say, age around 40 years or so, in much older individual, open heart surgery is performed. Yes or no? Tell me. Open heart surgery is performed. Everyone, what they do in that, they expose the heart. Getting my point? They take a blood vessel which is not that useful, okay, from the body itself. Okay, they will create an alternate pathway. They will bypass this clot. Now blood is not flowing through this, rather blood will flow through this, and this is going to be known as bypass surgery. Agreed? That is going to be known as bypass surgery. Have you people understood the meaning of word bypass? Tell me, dear. Heart attack, cardiac failure, and cardiac arrest. Yes, I will surely explain. Here, and I'm going to explain. Have you people understood what is angioplasty, what is angiography, and what is, you can say bypass surgery? In bypass surgery, actually we are bypassing it through this by connecting an artery across the clot, or the, you can say, this thing. Now, You are saying, sir, please explain between heart attack. See, what is heart attack? When this muscle is not getting oxygen, this muscle got damaged. That is heart attack. Yes or no? So irreversible damage to heart muscle or wall of heart is what? Heart attack. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Yes. Once this part of heart is damaged, do you think that heart is going to pump the blood like before? It is doing before? Is it like that? Yes or no? No. In that case, will the heart be able to meet the demand of your body? Will the heart meet you can say the demand of the body? Tell me. When heart will not be able to meet the demand of your body, yes, not fully, that is only heart failure. And if heart failure will be there, after some time, heart will start, you can say stop beating. You can say when heart will stop beating, that will be known as what? That will be known as what? Tell me. That will be known as heart. No. When heart will stop beating, that will be known as heart failure or cardiac failure. Yes. No. Please see to it. I think I have explained it wrongly. Heart failure is when it is not meeting the demand of the body, and cardiac arrest is when heart stops beating. Agreed? Cardiac arrest. Yes. Haryan, you are right. So the cardiac failure is when the heart is not able to, like see, in an exam, when do you fail? You are not going to get that much, you can say, number which is required. Yes or no? In that case, you say that somebody has failed. Shraddha, yes or no? Yes. Same is there with heart also. If heart is not able to meet the demand of the body, in that case, what will we say? We will say that heart has failed. And after many failures, heart will stop beating. That is arrest. Yes or no? I think I am able to explain to you people all these things. Now, one is a stroke. One is a stroke. What do you think? What is a stroke? What is a stroke? Tell me, dear. See, what happens with increasing age, blood vessel lose elasticity. Okay, blood vessel is no more elastic now. I told blood vessel is no more elastic now. In that case, at times what happens, if pressure will be there, blood vessel will rupture. Agreed? That can be known as a stroke also. Agreed? Please think all these things for 2 minutes. You people can think upon these things. These are very important things. Agreed? Anybody having doubt? Anybody having doubt? No? You people have understood all these things fully? Can cardiac arrest be reversed using bypass? No. Once heart, see, many things are there. You must have seen in the, you can say, pictures. After somebody has, you can say, fallen unconscious, they are pressing the chest with some iron-like thing. Yes or no? Have you seen that? That can be done. Once cardiac arrest had happened, no use of bypass surgery is there. You are not going to get that time. If for that much time, blood is not flowing, in that case, things will be difficult. Okay? No issues? Everyone. So this is there. Now, if we will talk about these things, one more thing I will like to tell you all. One is cardiac cycle. What is there? Cardiac cycle. Agreed? You people can do like this. Have you done like this before? You people keep on doing like this, na? You are going to feel some thrust from inside. Yes or no? You are going to feel some thrust from inside. What is that? That is actually contraction of ventricle. That is known as systole. And relaxation is known as diastole. So all the series of event that is taking place between consecutive heartbeat is known as cardiac cycle. All the series of event taking place between consecutive heartbeat is known as cardiac cycle. Yes or no? Everyone. Series of event taking place between consecutive heartbeat. Getting my point? Heart rate is 75 beats per minute. Agreed? So what do you think? What is the duration of one cardiac cycle? In 60 seconds, you are going to get 75 cycles. So for one cycle, it is around 0.8 second. Yes or no? Everyone. Here, if you people are going to divide them into 8 equal halves, this is 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8. Like that only. Getting my point? The contraction of atria is going to be there for 0.0 to 0.1 second. Okay? And atria is going to relax for 0.1 to 0.8 second. Yes or no? Everyone? Everyone, atria is going to contract for only 0.1 second and it will be relaxing for 0.7 second. Everyone, no issues? No issues, tell me dear. Now, if you will talk about ventricular event, ventricle is, you can say, contracting between 0.1 to 0.4 second, and for rest of the time it is relaxing. So can you people see, contraction is known as ventricular systole and rest is known as ventricular diastole. Yes or no? Now one thing I want to ask you all, see, from 0.4 to 0.8 second, what is there? From 0.4 to 0.2, you can say 8 second, what is there? Which is there in the systole and which is there in the diastole? Complete diastole. Both are there in the diastole. That is known as joint diastole, when both atria and ventricle are in diastole. Okay? you people can read a bit about heart sounds, and if you have any issues, you can ask. Okay. Now, one is excretory system. What do you know about excretory system? It is the excretion is elimination of metabolic waste. Do you people agree? Do you people agree? Excretion is excretion of metabolic waste. No issues. Now, if your food is carbohydrate, its metabolic waste will be CO2 and H2O. And if it is lipid, it will be ketone bodies. If it is protein, it is NH3, ammonia, and urea. Yes or no? Everyone. Getting my point? Have you people heard about hunger strike? That you can say people used to do for protesting. First, carbohydrate will be utilized. Then lipids will be utilized. And after that, muscle protein will be there. That is going to be utilized to produce energy. So, first 1 or 2 days, it will be all right. After that, once lipid will be start, you can say lipid will start breaking down, it will convert into ketone bodies. What? Yes or no? Yes or no? And this ketone bodies will come into urine. And that process is known as ketonuria. Yes or no? So if somebody will ask you in hunger strike, what can be the sign? That's you can say the person is sitting on hunger strike. What do you think? What should be there? Is it ketonuria? Because for first 1 or 2 days, the carbohydrate stored is going to provide you or provide that person with energy. Yes or no? Agreed? And after that, what will start breaking down? Tell me. Lipid. And once lipid will break down, what will be there in the body? Ketone bodies, na? And that ketone bodies will come into urine. That signifies that that person is sitting on hunger strike. Now, talking about excretory system, porifera, cylindrata, pinophora, and echinodermata is there. They do not have any excretory system. You are aware about the phylums, na? You people are aware about the phylums, na? These names? Yes. So these phylums do not have any excretory system in place. Platyhelminthes, flame cells and protonephridia. Ascalminthes, excretory tube with Raynaud cell. Annelida, nephridia is there. In arthropoda, class insecta, Malpighian tibule. Crustacean, the prawn is there, very delicious. Okay, green gland and or you can say or antennal gland. These are the names. Arachnids, coxal gland. In that, a scorpion and a spiders are there. Mollusca, Cabar's organ. This is important. Hemichordata, proboscis gland. Invertebrates, kidney is there. Yes or no? So that is there to be marked upon. So you people can learn a bit. Now, we'll talk about human excretory system. You see over here, human excretory system is consisting of 2 kidneys, ureter, okay, urinary bladder, and urethra. They are there. You see, this ureter is opening over here. This ureter is opening over here. And here is the opening of urethra is there. You will connect them. You will form a triangle. This is known as trigone. Yes or no? Everyone? Everyone? This is known as trigone. Now, can you observe this line? And please be agree with me. Observe this. Tell me, dear. Do you people agree? See, right kidney is on slightly on the lower side because on right side liver is there. Yes or no? Everyone? Yes. Right side liver is there. Now see, urethra having two sphincter. One is internal urethral sphincter, one is external urethral sphincter. Now, retroperitoneal organ is the kidney. Do you know what is the meaning of retroperitoneal? See, this is your anterior body wall towards stomach. This is your posterior body wall towards your back. You see, one peritoneum is going to line this. Another peritoneum is going to line this, like this. Okay, all your organ, the esophagus, the stomach, the intestine, the heart, all are present in this space. Okay, well covered by peritoneum. And this peritoneum is only going to be known as pericardium in heart, pleura in lung. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Everyone? Yes. But it is slightly different in case of kidney. It is situated over here, behind the peritoneum. Yes or no? And directly attached to the body wall. Peritoneum is above it. So kidney is retro, means behind, situated behind the peritoneum. Everyone? We'll talk about the structure of kidney. It is divided into outer cortical part and inner medullary part. Medulla of kidney is not continuous, rather in the form of renal medullary pyramid. Here is the, these are the medullary pyramids. Agreed, everyone? Now you see, this blue one is cortex. This blue one is cortex. This one is cortex. Now you see, can you see cortex extending between the medullary pyramid? Can you see that? Cortex is extending between medullary pyramid or not? Everyone? Yes. Sadda is saying yes. Rest are tired now? Not able to answer? Please, dear. Is the Hariharan is saying yes? Do you know what is that known as? That is known as renal column of Bottini. Part of renal cortex extending between renal medullary pyramid. Agreed? Is known as what? Extend, you see, na? It should be till here only, but it is not like that. It is going down also. So part of cortex extending between renal medullary pyramid is known as renal cortex. Now you see, this pyramid is going to open into minor calyx from here. Okay, few minor calyx are going to form major calyx. These major calyx will form the renal pelvis. And renal pelvis eventually opens into ureter. Yes or no? Do you people agree with this? Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Agreed, na? Completely agreed? Completely agreed with this? Now, you know that your kidney is going to be consists of nephron, which is the structural and functional unit of kidney. It is consisting of following parts. Nephron is consisting of glomerulus and renal tubule. Two segments are there. Renal tubule consisting of Bowman's capsule, loop of Henle, PCT, and DCT. Bowman's capsule, loop of Henle, PCT, and DCT. Yes or no? Tell me. Tell me, dear. There is one definition, that is of uriniferous tubule. It consists of It includes collecting duct also. It includes collecting duct also. No issues? So you see over here, this part is glomerulus. This part is glomerulus. Everyone, this part is glomerulus. This is Bowman's capsule. This one, this structure. In tubular part, this is PCT, this is Henle's loop. It is going down, hence descending limb of Henle's loop. This is going up, hence ascending limb of Henle's loop. Yes or no? This is DCT, this is collecting duct. Yes or no? Try to understand my point. Why this word proximal is used? Proximal means close. Close to Bowman's capsule is proximal, and away from Bowman's capsule is distal. Yes or no? Everyone, glomerulus and Bowman's capsule together known as Malpighian body or renal corpuscles. Yes or no? Everyone, Malpighian body or renal corpuscles, one thing. Now, one last thing that I will like to discuss with you all. Do you people know that descending limb of Henle's loop is permeable for water and ascending limb of Henle's loop is permeable for electrolyte? Do you people know that? Anyone of you? No, let's see. See, this is the descending limb. Now, do you people know the structure of plasma membrane? Do you people see that? You can say know that? So, yes. You know that this part, apart from head, is hydrophobic. Hydrophobic means water cannot pass through this on its own. Yes, agreed. Everyone agree? Let's see. Water cannot pass through this. So for that, one protein is there which comes from this side. You can start from this side and reach till here. Through this only water can pass. This is water channel. What is there? Water channel. This is known as aquaporins. What? Porins. Agreed? Everyone? This is known as aquaporins. Yes or no? Let's see. Let's see. Descending limb having those aquaporins, because of that only descending limb is permeable for H2O. H2O can come and go. Ascending limb do not have aquaporins, hence it cannot, you can say, move water across it. Yes or no? So descending limb is permeable for what? Descending limb is permeable for what? Water. And ascending limb is permeable for Na plus, K plus, like electrolyte. Agreed? So you people can see this thing. Rest we will be doing in the next class. Agreed? Good night, everyone.